is the purpose of living? Is there anybody who is living? Can I see one you are living? Why are you living? We may glorify God. Why are you living? Have you ever gone through something and you begin to think, I think this life is better I live than I go? How many have thought like that? At one moment, you, because of what you are going through, then you just thought, oh, man, it's better I leave this world. How many have thought like that? Yes. You think like that. Every human being, there are moments where you think, where am I living? And it's normal. Why do we come to that thought to say, why am I living? Because every human being, you are born to succeed in this world. And when you see things are not moving well, that's when we come to that conclusion, where am I living? Now you get the answer. You get the answer now? You have the answer? Yes! We are all born to succeed. To afyalikirwa okwikala life successfully. To achieve great things in this world. But each time we filter, we end up in our side about, oh my God, why am I living? Is it taken like this? It's better than I have. Hallelujah. Why? Because when we filter for lemon, these things must come in my way. I must have this. But it's not happening. Why am I living? Better I go. Hallelujah. That is a sign that surely we have a country where we came from. And we are sent as an ambassadors of Christ. Are you an ambassador?
Yes.
Who is an ambassador? It's true. Amen. That is the way. It's normal. That's why then we can say, but a normal human being will go through something, we come to that conclusion. Hallelujah. And let me tell you, even though I'm going to succeed in life, or go through something, then that question comes in, where am I living? It brought anger to achieve. Are you in the house? But if you are to pick up on it, you don't know that you support and you support. You are not going away. And in other words, you haven't discovered that you are born to succeed. If that thought has never come in your mind, Mr. Why is somebody that you are very clear to be successful, to achieve something great? Amen. Amen. By the time you go, you leave something legacy, the roadmap that others will follow. Amen. Amen. Never are you listening.
Never are you listening.
Never are you listening. Today, I want to talk something very important to our life. If you're not learned up, it's just a summary of what I'm about to speak today. I have a new topic here in front of me, which says the power of sacrifice. Touch on about the power of sacrifice. Is sacrifice of the Holy Testament? Sacrifice, is it for the Holy Testament? I touched this on Sunday. The power of sacrifice. Let's read the Bible from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 7 verse 2 to 14. But before we read, allow us to say, sacrifice is a prayer that we offer to God. Sacrifice is as good as fasting is to the child of God. Sacrifice, yawa ni prayer, iyo tupepa, fia fine fia ba fasting. When we fast, it's a turbocharger prayer. It's a four-wheel drive to your car. Amen. Fasting, yawa ni turbocharger or a four-wheel drive. It matters the situation you are facing in life. Then you say, I think I'm praying and these things are not changing. Let me fast. We had fasting because you are praying and things are not changing. That's why they're always fast. Is it true? In the Bible, you discover that kings used to declare the fasting when the kingdom is invaded by the enemies. The king will say, from this month or from this day and that day, the whole nation as a kingdom, we are going to fast as children of Israel. Amen. Why? Because grandfathers have actually intervened in what we are going through. So fasting is part of also prayer. I would say fasting is a four-wheel drive. So sacrifice, naena ni prayer, but munshlaimi. Amen. Hello. Touch on whenever you listen. So fasting, sacrifice, these are also prayers. Amen. Amen. Chief yenetele pitamo. Ngawapepa wapepa tafilechinja. We had fasting. You fast, fast tafilechinja. We had what? Sacrifice. Amen. Amen. There are three kinds of prayer. Fasting, sacrifice, and just a normal prayer. Amen. Yon saya masali. Amen. Now, nalana nati. In today's churches, there is no church without altar. Here the Lord healing last time, I speak about this altar. You know, to walk with the altar, I said the Lord told me to be the new altar, and we built, and we have seen miracles in our lives. We have seen the power of the altar. You talk about no change. Amen. Is it true? Yes. There's a grace and a mighty power from this water. Hallelujah. Now I say, what does the water mean? What is water? Water means the place of sacrifice. Amen. This water, it means the place of what? Sacrifice. You find this place. But some churches, they have not honored this place. Anybody climbs on it? Anyone who come? If whatever Karibu mema na wakwaleza, Abba. That's why they don't see God in their churches. I was at ECD. Prophet Shepherd Koshiri's church. They have an altar. A lot of men of him on the prophetic channel, you see that the man of God is not always on that altar. Because that place is reserved for God. Even Emmanuel TV, Prophet TV Joshua, when you never walk on the altar, you never walk on the altar. So in the churches, there are altars. I think that's from today. Jeremy. A long time, and it was 20 years, and all the house of Israel lament after the Lord. Verse 3, and Samuel spoke to the whole house of Israel and said, if you return to the Lord with all your hearts then put away the foreign gods and Ashtaroth from among you, and prepare your hearts for the Lord, and serve him only, and he will deliver you from the hand of the Philistines. Verse 4. So the children of Israel put away the Baals and the Ashtaroth, and serve the Lord only. And Samuel said, gather all the Israel to Mizpah, and I will pray to the Lord for you. So they gathered together at the Mizpah, draw water and pour out before the Lord. And they fasted that day. And they say, we have sinned against the Lord. And Samuel judged the children of Israel at Mizpah. Now let me just explain briefly what you just read here. Amen. The Bible learned that. Remember, at this time, yari ni ishtaya wana ba Israel. The act iakwale sama Philistians by Satan. Alright. They sinned against the Lord. So God was against the Israelites. Lesser than the Lord of Israel at this moment. Then Samuel the prophet, out of the light, look here. If you see from the Israelites, because they were complaining, child of God, life is not easy without God in your life. Sometimes when I see people who doesn't pray, when I see people, I wonder how they survive in this world. Never admire a sinner. Never envy a sinner. No matter how qualified somebody can be, no matter what time, whatever you may have, as long as doesn't have God in his life, never admire such a man or woman. You know, we have gone internet now. We are on YouTube. We are trying to use this foreign language so that our brother or somewhere they can understand us also. So I'm using double language. Marimana ndawamfia double language ayo. Kalalande sumba ikwiri kambaki mchiyo. So that you understand. Amen. So that na wala wale tutama pa YouTube, pa WhatsApp, and then whatever, they are able to understand what we are doing here. Amen. Are we together? So element, never admire a sinner. The Bible says do not envy an evil person. No matter if you end up water, as long as that water is, never admire such a man. Touch a neighbor, never admire a sinner. Never envy a sinner. That's what the Bible said. Their life is not easy. It's a difficult life they lead. They walk with frustration hearts. Then they need to be a companion. They don't sleep well. Night is not night. Hallelujah. Life is so difficult to live without God. Sometimes, I don't know what you're saying. So I am teaching to say, now, why in life you must come to your senses and think again and say, surely I am without God and there is God on my side. Amen. Let me go back to my God. That is the normal. Amen. If you don't think to come back to the Lord, Munina, you will die miserably. Israel, they thought, you said, no way we can be suffering like this, and yet we have our God. It's like that young man who went away. Muchiano said, womanizing, clubbing, doing everything. The Bible said, when he came back to his mind, that's why anybody who is doing evil in the world, they are not in their mind. Any doubts?
Yes.
You can agree with me. Some of you that certain things if your marriage stuff, you know when you remember, you say, it wasn't me. Is it true?
Yes.
God, if your marriage down in at one time before you accept Jesus. But after you meet Jesus in your life, today, when you remember these things you were doing it, hey, you say, was it me? Did you know when I reached it? Why did I do it anyway? It will you are not in your mind. Anybody is not born again, they are not normal. They are not normal people. And also the Bible said they are dead men but are walking. Touch your neighbor, neighbor, you listening. Amen. Any of Jesus is a dead man but walking. And they are not in their mind. Devil has captured them. Read the Bible. Pray for those who are in captivity of Satan. Satan, he always used them as his one will. Are you in the house? Me, I've heard the stories where somebody, after a pangan, they were in Uka. After a stand, she was talking about 19 hours, by Gram, Sabalas. But two shepherd, 21 hours, and I saw one of them in India. Amy, the Google 04. Is it in his mind?
No.
If you ask him, rather than anybody, sometimes when you arrive home at 21, will you be home again? Could you have Baba at 21? No way. Why? Because you are in your mind. But our name is who? Our shall my mind here. The devil wakes in their brains. 21 hours he can leave home. Now, somebody should take off the car. If you're feeling Milo, I doubt. When the man, you know, I'm a fashion, Bali is starting. We should Tabaisha, Tabali is a Namishma Samba. By the nature of the Nazan State and a woman who had talked to a million and longer. We shall be shutting Paul and you. They are not in their minds. Hallelujah. So let's go back. The Bible says the Israelites were in Uchula. Now they came back to their mind, their sins, and said, no way. If it were the Guadalessa and the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God who keeps the covenant, this is our God. Let's go back. And there is a prophet Samuel. Are you in the house?
Yes.
Pastor, why are we suffering? Why am I going through this problem? And yet, we have our God. And there's a prophet, Charles. Oh, prophet. Yes. 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 Are you in the house?
Yes.
They are suffering somewhere. They are trying to come. But I'm thinking, are they going to accept us? Are you ready to overcome them?
Yes!
I see a lot of them coming back.
Yes.
Why am I going through what I'm going through? By the time I was a world healing church, there was a kind of favor in my life. My business was booming. My marriage was okay. My working place had a favor. But from the time I left, things are not well. Come back, sister. Hallelujah! Touch on the name of your descending here. So the Israelites said, we have the prophet Samuel. To Aikwataka Sesema, Samuel! Samuel, please, can you cry for us to your God? Very amakataya. And what did Samuel told them? Samuel said, can you move away from these idols, the Baal and Ashtoreth? You know, Astro is a god who was in the business of fertility. Hallelujah. Sexual things, that was their god. Like in Corinth. In Corinth, there was a demon, there was a temple where prostitutes would be 1,000 prostitutes in the church. And the people would go there and worship and sleep with them. Hallelujah.
And this is the God of Israel, Bible involved. And the Samuel said, can you run away from this idol? Then God will answer your prayer. Run away from your problems and God will answer your prayer. Touch the button, listen. We went as far as verse 7. Okay, let's read verse 5. And Samuel said, gather all Israel to Mizpah, and I will pray to the Lord for you. Have you seen? So they gathered together at Mizpah, draw water and pour it out before the Lord. And they fasted that day. And they say there, we have sinned against the Lord. And Samuel judged the children of Israel at Mizpah. Now, when the Philistines heard that the children of Israel had gathered together at Mizpah, the lords of the Philistines went up against Israel. And when the children of Israel heard of it, they were afraid of the Philistines. Do not fear them. But you know what? When you are in sin, fear creeps in. It's not easy for any man or woman to stand and face the trouble when you are away from the Lord. Tachave chango ka ukwiminina iyo ni mulubembu. Mulubembu lulembu wa mtu wale mtuka na vane pa wala baronga na namu. Are you that? Me, I've heard the stories where somebody will run away from you as a member in that church. But what is the problem now? That means somebody is not living well, he's in sin. Hallelujah. That's what never you listen. Name of Shemuel. So the Bible says when Samuel begin to intercede for the Israel to go back to me. My Philistines, for them, they thought this gathering they want to attack us. Let me tell you. Each time you are praying, the moment you kneel down and begin to pray, that is battle. Amen. Any prayer you knew. If when a pakulala, pakulia, with any time, no one come up, the enemy consider it is battle. Alam mo shooting na maros. Hello, some of you, after prayer, have na chota manambo chifi de wino. Any prayer you pray is a battle in the kingdom of Satan. Some of you don't know you don't know yourself. They got a man shumari ishwaini. The moment you kneel down, where the pakuria, pakuuka, whatever the time you say, in the name Munina, in the camp of the enemy, they consider it to be a battle prayer. That's why each time you say, I want to pray, make sure you are serious with what you are doing there. Now some of you are praying anywhere. Jesus. You've been in trouble, Nina. How many can agree as it's true? It has happened to me once or twice or many times. After you pray, not a serious prayer, but you don't sleep well. I mean, agree. Yes, sir. Why? Because your enemy consider every prayer you kneel down to pray is a battle. When I say Jesus, when in the name of, do you know how that name sound in the kingdom of Satan? When you just say in the name of the opposition of body panology, that name is so loud in the kingdom of Satan. And the enemy you want to see, who shout Jesus?
And they will start looking for you. Again, Jesus said, oh, he's here. Valeration, no protection. They will slap you. Jesus. Demons move everywhere every time. Let me tell you, human beings are not busy. Demons are so busy more than human beings. They know their time is limited. And last time I learned that Ingulushari was so serious more than even you yourself. And that's why this message has come for us. The enemy are so serious to sacrifice against your name, against your business, against your marriage. You are not serious. Look at these people. They just gather for prayer. In the camp of the enemies, the Philistines, they consider they have gathered in a battle. Let's go and attack them. This is what it means each time you kneel down, you want to pray. Your enemy consider it is battle. Because the name Jesus is so sharp and powerful. Touch on the neighbor you listening in.